So it has been announced that the Lakers have signed Frank Mason III to a non-guaranteed training camp deal, and he'll look to fight for a place on LA's roster. Whether it be on the big team or in the G League, he'll be a solid insurance option if some of the Lakers' point guards get injured or need rest, and he would be a nice call-up option compared to the other guards on the market. But not many people know about Frank Mason III, so let's go over his background, what his game is like, and what his potential can be for LA. And very quickly, before we get into it, if you want to see more interesting NBA content just like this, be sure to drop a like and subscribe, as I really appreciate our guys' support. So Frank Mason III is a 5'10 point guard who is 27 years old and has played 4 seasons in the NBA. For his career, he has averaged 6.7 points, 2.6 assists, and 2 rebounds in only 15.7 minutes per game, mainly playing a backup point guard role. He's a quick guard who handles the ball well, and this is shown in his 2.6 to 1.1 assist to turnover ratio. He has spent both time in the big leagues and in the G League, where he was recently named the 2019-20 G League MVP. During that season, he showed a 3-level scoring ability that led to a 26 point per game average on about 50-42-82 shooting splits. However, this has not been able to translate yet at the NBA level, as in the NBA for his career, he's shooting only 39.6% from the field and 30.1% from downtown. But the potential and flashes have always been there, and if everything clicks, he can be a great scorer who can help spread the floor with his 3-point shot and break down defenses and draw fouls with his driving ability. If he gets minutes with the LA Lakers, I could see him being a solid player in spot bench minutes, if there are injuries, being a good scorer and playmaker off the pick and roll with someone like Dwight Howard or DeAndre Jordan. On defense, it's pretty obvious to say, but Mason will likely be a pretty big liability when on the floor. He hustles and is quick, but that can only do so much when you're 5'10". He's going to be prone to getting picked on switches where opposing players can shoot over him or back him down in the post. But if Vogel can find a way to hide him on defense when he plays or pairs him up with versatile defenders around him, there is a way to still make him an overall net positive if he's able to get everything to click on offense. Overall, this is a low-risk signing for the Lakers that will likely lead to Mason being sent to play with the South Bay Lakers and potentially get a call-up if there are any injuries at the point guard spot. Mason is a solid insurance option in the G League, and his quickness provides an interesting player to have during the Lakers training camp. We'll see what happens, but this was a decent signing for LA that could be great if Mason is able to put his offensive game together at the NBA level. So that's a wrap. Thank you guys all for watching. If you guys did enjoy this video and want some more daily NBA content just like this, be sure to drop a like and subscribe, and also be sure to turn on post notifications so you can stay updated on when this video will be coming out. Also, be sure to follow me on IG and hit me up if you want to talk about basketball or business. Just drop a comment down below my photos or DM me, and I'll definitely try it back to most of you guys there. Drop a comment down below on your thoughts on the signing. Do you think Frank Mason III will see minutes with the Lakers, or do you think he'll mainly stay in the G League? Let me know, as I do read comments. Definitely interested to see what you guys have to say here as well. So with all that being said, once again, thank you guys all for watching. Hopefully I will see you on the next video. Peace.